Starting recording. Chitram bateta dekena.
Chitram bateta ekena.
Ekena.
Vapusa yugapat pritak.
Vapusa yugapat pritak.
Griheshu dvasta sahasram. स्त्रिया एक उदावहत इट इज अस्टाउंडिंग दैट लॉर्ड श्री कृष्णा हु इज विदाउट अ सेकंड एक्सपैंडेड हिमसेल्फ इनटू 16,000 सिमिलर फॉर्म्स टू मैरी 16,000 क्वींस इन देयर रेस्पेक्टिव होम्स. We'll move on. This verse from Srimad Bhagavatam.
Prabhu?
Yeah, sorry.
No, no, Prabhu, go ahead, Prabhu. So I was reading this particular verse, Prabhu. like I was reading Krishna book. So in Krishna book, Prabhu, Prabhupada mentions the opulence of Lord Krishna. The opulence of Lord Krishna. So here it is specifically mentioned. Krishna married to 16,108, and so from each wife he begot 10 sons, right?
Yes.
So, and for the tuitions, for the tuition of the their specific sons, right? So they appointed 8 lakhs teachers, some Vedic teacher to give the tuition to Krishna's son,
8 lakh people, okay, huge.
8 lakh Vedic, Vedic teachers to give that tuition to Krishna's son. And also that is a pastime also when Narad came, right, to see the, to see the Lord Krishna in Dwaraka. Since Krishna married to 16,108 Lakshmis, for each of them, he built a new palace, right, Prabhu? And when he see Krishna, he expanded himself to 16,108. And from each household, he's doing some different pastimes, right? He goes to ask how it's possible, since he knows, right, he's a great devotee, so he knows that he's a supreme person, so he can do anything.
Right.
So just want to say that.
No, that is a very beautiful point. Thank you for bringing that up. Because, a lot of people say, we can become God or whatever. But can you even do what Krishna did? Having 16,000 palaces and 160,000 kids and 8 lakh teachers to teach them. It is simply not possible to imitate Krishna. All the people try. It is simply not possible.
Yes, Prabhu. Also, another thing, Krishna, since Krishna married, so the main chief queen is Rukmini, right? So the son of Rukmini is Pradyumna. And then Pradyumna's son is Anirudh. So then there is a descendant, and still, Krishna's, the descendants are in the family succession. So still Krishna was 16-year-old, Prabhu. How amazing it is.
Yeah, that is true. That is the most mysterious part. He has big kids, but he's never Yavanamcha, always 16. Always youth.
Always 16.
Right. Always. Very, very good point. Thank you.
The one of the Krishna's son, that they are so powerful. They can fight with 10,000 elephants at a time. They are so powerful. Krishna begot sons. They are so powerful. So it was also mentioned in the Krishna book reading. So Prabhupada mentioned this point.
Very good. Very good. Yeah. Thank you. Okay, so thank you, Sarvana, for joining. Now let's go to the next verse. Rasotsavaha sampravritto.
Rasotsavaha sampravritto.
Gopi mandala manditaha.
Gopi mandala manditaha.
Yogeshwarena Krishnena.
योगेश्वरेण कृष्णेन
तासां मध्ये द्वयोर्द्वयोः When Lord Sri Krishna, surrounded by a group of cowherd girls, began the festivities of Rasa dance, the Lord of all mystic powers placed himself between each two girls. So he was like, you know, appearing to everyone in a close proximity. It's not like he's far away. Between every two cowherd damsels, girls, he would place himself between two gopis. Again, this is from Srimad Bhagavatam. And Srimad Bhagavatam 10th canto is Krishna book. So it all comes back to Krishna book. Pravistena grihitanam.
Pravistena grihitanam.
Kante swanikitam striyaham.
Kante swanikatam striyaham.
Yam manyeran nabhastavad.
अति
औत्सुक्य वृतात्मानाम् ततो दुंदु भयो निधुर निपेतुः पुष्पवृष्टयः Okay, let's go to the When the cowherd girls and Krishna thus joined together, each girl thought Krishna was dearly embracing her alone. So he's giving, you know, each one of them private darshan. To behold this wonderful pastime of the Lord, the denizens of heavens and their wives were all eager to see the dance, flew in their sky in their hundreds of airplanes. They showered flowers and beat sweetly on drums. So think about, as we briefly discussed last time, even the denizens of heaven, were very happy because they cannot go to Goloka Vrindavan to see Krishna. But they were able to see Gokula Krishna, Gokula Vrindavan. So they were in their balconies, right? They are higher up than us. So from their balconies, they take these shuttles and then they come out and shower flowers. So it is just like in the Star Wars movie, right? They show these drones coming out from balconies. So all those ideas are from these scriptures only. So where did they get the idea that drone should be parked in the balconies and they'll come out and all that? So all this is from the scriptures. So Radha Krishna Prabhu from ISKCON Houston, he was saying, everything that is there in Srimad Bhagavatam, somebody from Hollywood has, you know, taken these ideas and made movies out of them. But of course, they will not talk about Krishna. They will just put some Western twist to it. And same thing they did with Greek literature and so on, right?
So here too, I'd like to add one point, Prabhu, here. So since, you know, Krishna's, the Rasa dance usually lasts for for midnight and it's in around 4 a.m. morning time. It looks like in the metal eyes, it looks like 4 hours, but ideally, I again read the same thing from the Krishna book. Prabhupada, there it is mentioned, So the Rasa dance, it goes for millions of years. So in material eyes, it looks like it's a 4 hours of Rasa dance in Vrindavan, like in our material world, but it's lasts for millions of years.
Right. That's a very good point. That's an excellent point because time dilates. Even the scientists are agreeing now that time dilates. Vedic time. If you see this, there are some images. not this, like Manvantara and all that, right? Vedic time. Manvantara, that graphical picture. Yeah, this one. This is developed by these ISKCON people, which is more authentic than some of the other things. They're also correct, but not too much detail. So life of Brahma is 311 trillion years. From there, it's 4.32 billion years is Kalpa. So the Rasa dance lasts longer than the life of Brahma. You think about it. It is trillions of years, actually. Because Brahma takes birth and dies while Rasa dance is happening. So think about how long the Rasa dance happens. So for us, it is almost like eternally this is going on, right? From our perspective, it's almost like Rasa dance is going now. Rasa dance was happening before our class, and Rasa dance will happen after our class. So it is continuously going on. We are only talking about Krishna for a very small fraction of a nanosecond. But Rasa dance is eternally going on. So we are somewhere here in Kali Yuga, in the Pradama Pade, Jambudvipe, America Khande, Seattle Nagare. And we are having class for just 1 hour out of these 432,000 years. So think about, if you go here, what is that in comparison to life of Brahma? It is not even a fraction of a nanosecond, very small. And life of Brahma itself is very small compared to Rasa dance duration. So yeah, it is mind-boggling actually. Cannot even imagine how these timings work. If numerous forms, all equal in their features, are displayed simultaneously, such forms are called Prakasha Vigraha. That's it. It's just a name. The title of Prakasha Vigraha is the numerous forms which are equal in features are displayed simultaneously. That is Prakasha Vigraha. Vilasa Vigraha has a different meaning. So last time we talked about it, right? It is like polymorphism and inheritance. So this is an example of polymorphism. Lord can expand into multiple morphs or multiple, similar Vigrahas, equal in their features. So just like in C++, you create a class and then you morph it many times. So you can call the same class from different programs. And in memory, the class instantiates and does whatever it needs to do. So very similar to our concepts of polymorphism come from spiritual concepts of polymorphism. So Laghu Bhagavatamrita, very advanced book, very beautiful book actually, where Gopakumara is asking, who is the greatest, who is the greatest? And finally, they come to the conclusion, they go to Hanuman. Hanuman says, I am not the greatest. Look at all these other great devotees. Then they go to the great devotee. They say, we are not the greatest. Look at all these great devotees. Then they say, no, we are not the greatest. Look at all these gopis, manjaris. And manjaris say, we are not the greatest. The gopis are the greatest. And gopis say, we are not the greatest. Radharani is the greatest. So the chain stops there. So Radharani is the greatest devotee of Lord Krishna. That's why in Vrindavan, people say Radhe Radhe. Don't even say Hare Krishna. Because they're saying, if you give Radha, Krishna is automatically going to come around Radha. So, they are very tricky. They say, just pray to Radha. Krishna is already there. So that's how they approach it in a very backdoor manner. Ekai vigraha kintu akare haya ana.
Ekai vigraha kintu akare haya ana.
Aneka prakasha hai vilasa taranama.
Aneka prakasha hai vilasa taranama.
But when numerous forms are slightly different from other, they are called vilasa vigraha. Right? So this is loosely, you could call it inheritance. Polymorphism we talked about. Inheritance is, so a class may have 20 methods at the parent level. When you inherit the class, you take out one method. So there are only 19 methods. And from that 19 method, you inherit again, you only have 18 methods. So similarly, Goloka Krishna is there 100%. By the time you come to Ayodhya, Lord Rama has slightly less features. Then you come to the Chaturvyuha expansions, slightly less features. Then you come to Karnodakshaya Vishnu, slightly less features. So although Karnodakshaya Mahavishnu is inherited from the Vasudeva Sankarsana Aniruddha Pradyumna, features are little less. So, I mean, again, I'm just giving you a material example. In spirituality, I don't know how it works because I have not gone to the spiritual world yet. So when I go, I can tell you. But this is how we can loosely understand it. That there is slight difference that is called Vilasa Vigraha.
Can you repeat that one more time, Prabhu, this particular verse?
This one?
Vilasa Vigraha.
Yeah.
Yes, Prabhu.
So when the numerous forms, remember there are numerous forms, there are infinite number of forms of the Lord. Only some of the forms we see in the material world.
Right.
When the numerous forms are slightly different from one another, it's called Vilasa Vigraha. Prakasha Vigraha is just multiple instantiations, right? You create a program once and you instantiate many times. But Vilasa Vigraha, it is inheritance. Slightly different, like you may have, just like I was giving example of the C++ class. You write the parent class and the child class may have, parent may have 20 methods, child class may only have 19 methods. So it is the same thing. It is doing the same functionality, except that one thing it is not doing anymore. That's how it is. So similarly, Goloka Krishna expands as Ayodhya Rama. Ayodhya Rama has slightly less features than Krishna. The Chaturvyuha expansions have slightly less feature than Ayodhya Rama. The Karnodakshaya Mahavishnu has slightly less features than the Vasudeva Sankarsana Aniruddha Pradyumna, the Chaturvyuha expansions.
Okay.
Yes, Prabhu. Thank you.
Again, as I said, right, I have not been to the spiritual world, so I don't know. We are only following scriptures. Swarupam anyakaram yat.
Swarupam anyakaram yat.
Tasya bhati vilasatah. प्रायेनात्मा समं शक्त्याम् सविलासो निगद्यते When the Lord displays numerous forms with different features by his inconceivable potency, such forms are called Vilasa Vigraha. This is just like a revision. He's just revising what he said in the previous verse. Numerous forms. Yaiche Bala Deva Paravyome Narayana.
Yaiche Bala Deva Paravyome
Narayana.
Very good, baby. Yai che vasudeva pradyumnadi sankarshana.
Yai che vasudeva pradyumnadi sankarshana.
So now he is giving you the other thing that I just discussed. Remember, I said, you know, there are multiple forms, but there are multiple intermediate forms between what I said. Baladeva comes out of Krishna first. Paravyoma Narayana. Right? Then Vasudeva, Pradyumna, Sankarshana, Aniruddha come out. So it's giving the sequential expansion. Examples of such Vilasa Vigrahas are Baladeva, Narayana and Vaikuntha Dham and Chaturvyuha, Vasudeva, Sankarsana, Pradyumna and Aniruddha. I think it is clear. Ishvare Rashakti Haya Eti Na Prakaram.
Ishvare Shakti Haya Eti Na Prakaram.
Eka Lakshmi Gana Pure Mahishi Ganaram.
Eka Lakshmi Gana Pure Mahishi Ganaram.
व्रजे गोपी गण आर सबते प्रधान राजेन्द्र नंदन यते स्वयं भगवान The energies, consorts of the Supreme Lord are three kinds. Lakshmis in Vaikuntha, queens of Dwaraka, and gopis in Vrindavana. So this theme has been there since verse 3 of this Chaitanya Charitamrita. You remember we talked about this maybe 4 weeks ago? The same concept is continuing because just like the Lord is expanding, boom, 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 now the inheritance is happening with less and less features. Similarly, on the right side, Radharani is expanding. Lakshmi is in Vaikuntha, queens of Dwaraka, gopis in Vrindavan. So these expansions are also happening. The gopis are best of all. However, gopis are best. Even better than Lakshmi's. See, sometimes it is said that Lakshmi Devi gets a little angry and proud on her husband. She gets angry on her husband. And then at one time she comes down and then the Lord also comes down and he becomes Balaji in the Tirumala Hills. Right? We know the story. The queens of Dwaraka also occasionally... Yeah, sorry.
We don't know the story. If you can give 2 to 3 minutes to narrate the story, we will get Prabhu.
Okay. So I will have one of the other students do that. Shiva or Sarvana, do you know the story of how Lord Balaji came down?
Yes, Prabhu. I will try, Prabhu.
Okay. So try and then Shiva will correct you if you make a mistake.
Sure, Prabhu. So previously there was a debate about debate within the saints about who is the Supreme Lord, and the onus was on sage Bhrigu to find out who is the greatest of all, is it Brahma or Vishnu or Shiva. So to find out that Bhrigu Muni went to first to Brahma. Brahma was didn't care about. I think Brahma didn't notice Bhrigu Muni, and Bhrigu Muni became angry, and I think he went again to Shiva. So Shiva was having Shiva didn't notice again Bhrigu Muni, and he was actually enjoying his pastimes with Parvati, Mother Parvati, and so Bhrigu Muni cursed him, saying that you will not be worshipped and you will be worshipped only in linga form.
Actually, then, here, little correction, Prabhu. So when he go to Lord Shiva, so Lord Shiva recognized him because since Bhrigu Muni is the brother of Lord Shiva, right? So what happened? Bhrigu Muni soon Shiva came to embrace Bhrigu Muni, but Bhrigu Muni didn't respond. To check how Shiva is grateful or not. So that's the reason Shiva got angry, and he was supposed to open his third eyes, but how he managed it, since he knows that, Shiva knows that I'm not the supreme, that's why he managed it, didn't do anything to any harmful to Bhrigu Muni, because Mother Parvati was present there, and that's why Shiva got cooled down, and then he again go to Setadipa, like not original Vaikuntha, he went to the Setadipa. Setadipa is a material world, which is exist in between the spiritual world and the material world. But Setadipa is material world, but is not considered as a material world. In Setadipa, so Vishnu is there. Vishnu is lying there. So he went to the Setadipa. So just want to correct you, thank you.
Oh, sure, Prabhu. So, yeah, I don't exactly recall, Prabhu. So that's why, probably, please continue, Prabhu. Maybe I'm giving the wrong information. I don't want to give the wrong information. So please continue, Prabhu.
I know only story till I know till story about Vaikuntha. So when he went to the Setadipa, so there, so Lakshmi Narayan was there, and so the Lakshmi and Narayan, they are enjoying their pastimes, and they didn't notice, they didn't notice the Bhrigu Muni. So in anger, so Bhrigu Muni, he just punched the chest of Lord Vishnu.
I think he kicked Prabhu. He kicked the chest of.
He kicked the chest of Lord Vishnu, and then Vishnu so Lakshmi, Mother Lakshmi was there. She was got very angry, and because of these particular actions. But the Lord Vishnu, instead of doing any kind of any kind of anger or any kind of wrath. So instead, he in this sense he's trying to pacify the Bhrigu Muni. So he said that since your chest is so pious, your lotus feet is so pious, so that I can keep it in my heart. So like that, he just Lord Vishnu glorifies instead of giving some cause or some anger, something like that, he glorifies Bhrigu Muni. So then after Bhrigu Muni realized that he is the supreme, and after such incident, I kicked him, even though he didn't react, still he's glorifying me, the devotee. Since Bhrigu is the great devotee, right? So, and so that's the reason then Bhrigu Muni concluded that, so Lord Vishnu is the supreme. So this is the story I know, Prabhu. So he continued the rest Balaji story, I don't know, Prabhu.
Yeah, so at that point, because Mother Lakshmi resides in the chest of the Lord when she is not serving his feet, she becomes very angry. How can an ordinary sage hit me and kick in the place where I am residing? And my husband didn't do anything to protect me. So she becomes angry. She says, okay, I'll descend down to material world. I will just go there out of anger. And then, of course, Lord Narayana or Vishnu has to follow, right? Because to keep the balance, Lord Vishnu's business is always to keep balance between devatas. If his wife gets angry, if Mother Parvati gets angry, if Shiva gets angry, because he never gets angry. He's always sweet and smiling. He's in the mode of goodness. Shiva is attached to the mode of ignorance. Not like he's ignorant, but that's his duty. For his administration of material world and so on. And Brahma for creation and procreation. That's why he creates all the Prajapatis who do the procreation. So the point I was trying to make is, even Lakshmi, sometime they get angry at their husband. But gopis are best of all. Why? Because even if Krishna doesn't show up, they get angry at him in a sense that, why is Krishna ignoring us? But they never really get angry at him. They're always subordinate and subservient to Lord Krishna. That's why they are considered best of all. Even the queens of Dwaraka, like Satyabhama, sometimes demands, Krishna, do this for me. Krishna, do that. Get me the Parijata tree. Get me this. Get me that. Right? Just like, in the material world, there's a lot of demands. Not all of them, but many women demand, even though the husband doesn't have money, I want to buy this. So then the husband goes into debt, credit card debt, or take a loan and things like that. So that kind of demands are there, but gopis never demand anything. They'll say, if Krishna wants to trouble us, let him trouble. He is our unconditional Lord. Mat prana natastu eva napara. Chaitanya Shishashtakam, right? Yata tatha va vidadatu lampato mat prana natastu sa eva naparaha. Means, yata tatha, whatever you want to do, Krishna, do it. I don't care. You are my natha, my boss, my husband, my everything, right? So that is why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came down to teach us Gopi Bhav, how to, get to Krishna through the lens of the gopis. Otherwise, we could be staying in the Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya and just do a lot of pujas, put Lakshmi Narayan on the altar and do some offerings and later on and go watch TV. But no, here Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is teaching us something very special. TV or no TV, Krishna, whatever you want, I will do it for you. If you want me to break the TV, I'll break the TV. I won't even watch it. If you want to sell my car and go walking to office, I will do it. Whatever you want, Krishna. See, there is a very big difference, right? In Lakshmi Narayan worship, you are worshipping Lakshmi Narayan for their mercy. But you are not saying, do whatever you want to do with me, my Lord, right? Whereas in the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Parampara, we say, Krishna, you decide what you want to do. If you want to fire me, fire me. If you want to lay me off, lay me off. I know one devotee, his house got foreclosed, but he was not disturbed. He was saying, okay, this is what Krishna wants. It's okay. And he went and lived in a smaller place. That's okay. I know one person in ISKCON, Miami. He had $3 million. And then he said, some or the other, Krishna took it all away. I mean, somebody will put a lawsuit. Somebody will say, oh, this property is mine. Or the tax collector will come and say, you didn't pay taxes for whatever reason. Some or the other, he lost all his property, lives in a rented house. But he says, he's still a pujari in ISKCON, Miami. From $3 million sports car, he asked me, when I used to work in Miami, he used to ask me to drop him at his home. So I would pick him up from the temple. I used to live in the temple also for some time in the Brahmachari ashram, although I was not a Brahmachari. That's a long story. But anyway, so I used to drop him at his home. Now, from having a sports car, $3 million, to requesting somebody to drop him at his home, that is his situation. But he's saying, Krishna, whatever you want. You know, this material world is like that. Sometimes we have money, sometimes we don't have money. That's okay. So that is the mood that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Swami Prabhupada are teaching us, right? Because we all know the Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya, very glorious worship, big temples. But there we don't say, whatever you want, Krishna, I will do. No, we'll say, Krishna, I'll worship you so that you give me money. That's why we do Lakshmi worship, right? So, and here what we say, nadanam, najanam, nasundarim. Very different. We are saying, don't give us money, Krishna. And people say, Are Baba, then why worship God? He is not going to give you money. He's going to take your money away. So people are afraid actually to do Radha Krishna worship. Because when you do Radha Krishna worship, you'll have more problems than before. Right? If you do Lakshmi Narayan worship, you'll get more wealth. But Radha Krishna, although they are the same, you know, the superset of Lakshmi Narayan, very different. He will actually take away your money. So when you say Hare means take away, take me, that's what it means. Take me, my Lord. So you are not asking for money, give me money. You're saying take me. Money or no money, doesn't matter, just take me with you to the spiritual world. So that's why gopis are the best. And Kulashekar Alvar from the Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya used to pray, Krishna Twadiya Pada Pankaja Panjarantam Advaitume Vishatu Manasa Raja Hamsaha Prana Prayana Samaye Kapavit Vata Pittaudhi Kanto Varadho Vidhav Smaranam Kutaste. At the time of my death, I may not be able to remember you, Krishna. Right now, I'm very healthy, so take me away right now. You see that? And if you tell this to your wife and kids or husband and kids, they'll say, no, nothing doing. You have to stay here till we grow old. You demand, right? The wife will demand, husband, you have to live with me. Take care of me. And husband will say, wife, hey, where are you going? No spiritual world business. Stay with me till we grow old and then you can die. So that is our mentality. But Gopi's mentality is everything for you, Krishna, everything.
Okay, we are in that talking about Balaj, right? Is that finished?
Oh, that is in. I'll show you where it is. You can go after the class.
Balaji's Lord Balaji's pastimes. There are lots of characters that we need to remember.
No, this is not in relation to Lord Balaji. This is Mukunda Mala Stotram. I don't think. They didn't post it here. Let me do. Yeah, there's so many lectures. But my point is, I don't want to go into that whole lecture. I want to just show you where it is.
That's the reason Mother Lakshmi came to the metal world, and then after Lord Vishnu also came to the metal world and become Balaji. That is the story of the book?
Yes, yeah. So when he comes down, he becomes Balaji. So Balaji is not an incarnation, in case you didn't know. He's directly Lord Vishnu.
So in the Balaji temple also, Mother Lakshmi also there?
Yes, of course. Sri Devi and Bhu Devi. Mother Lakshmi then expands into two.
Okay, we can move next to.
Yeah. I want to show you that. It is very good.
Is there, because I don't, I like in the spiritual, for Lord Balaji, I don't have much like pastimes or knowledge on that. If I have anything to go to,
no, if you go to
know about Lord Balaji.
Yeah, if you go to Tirumala Tirupati Devasthanam, and I'll show you how to get there. Let me show you that. ttd.org.
But even the passings of Lord Balaji is in the, it's in one of the cantos, right? In Prabhu in Srimad Bhagavatam. Wherein,
it is there, but if you want to know how Tirumal Tirupat Devastaram explains it, you can go there as well. There are many ways to go there. This is very different. This is TTD Tirumala.
What is the story about Prabhu? Why people go there and donate so huge amount, Prabhu? What is the story behind this?
They basically give the hair, right? So that to show that you have surrendered to the Lord. Because hair is considered a beauty for a man or woman. That's why they buy wig and put on their head. So they give hair. And the donations is because the Lord takes a loan supposedly from Kubera, the Devata for wealth. Anyway, this site is not working now. So he takes money from the Kubera, the scientist, for his marriage, supposedly. And in order to repay that loan, it comes. That's just an excuse. Balaji's main point is you have to surrender your entire living, your soul to him. But then if you have too much money, then you'll get attached. So give the money first. That's what he says, right?
Okay.
Right? So if you look at Balaji, I hope they show the real Balaji and not some old Balaji. Yeah. You see this? He's saying, he puts his hand like this to show that the shelter is at his lotus feet. And the second one, he's saying, give me your wealth so that you don't get attached to your wealth.
Okay.
Yeah. There is significance for everything in scriptures. Most people don't know these things. Thanks to Prabhupada, we know all these things.
Prabhu, another question. So like for Lord Jagannath, so we have so many references in the scriptures, like the Skanda Puran, right? And also Brahma Vaibhav Puran. So there are so many references to Lord Jagannath, right? Dadu Brahma Rupa, right? Dadu Brahma. So is there like, what are the scriptures where it refers to the Lord Balaji?
Yeah, there is scriptures. If you go to Tirumal Tirupat Devasthanam, let me find it and I'll, send it to the group. I think now, are you in the group like for our class?
In WhatsApp, no, I don't. I'm not there. You can add me there.
Chaitanya. Okay.
Yeah, here,
right? So let me add you in. Group info, add participant. Let me see if your name gets picked up. Okay, I'll have to add you after class. I'll add you, okay?
Okay, so no problem. Yeah. Okay, we can go ahead and we can start, from where we left to look.
Yeah. Swayam Rupa Krishnera Kaya Vyuhatan Rasamam.
Swayam Rupa Krishna Kaya Vyuhatan Rasamam.
Bhakta Sahite Haya Tanara Avarana.
Bhakta Sahite Haya Tanara Avarana.
The personal associate of the primeval Lord Sri Krishna are his devotees, who are identical with him. He is complete with his entourage of devotees. Right? So always when the Srila Prabhupada disciples went to Prabhupada and they drew a picture of Krishna, he said, where are the devotees? Krishna is never alone. He's always with his entourage. Tour means like he's always going somewhere with a tour, with a set of people. Entourage means people who follow him in that tour. Right? So where are his devotees? He asked him. He said, go back and draw all the devotees and bring the painting back to me. Right? So Krishna should be never drawn alone. He should be with Radharani at a minimum, with the gopis around at a minimum. And after that, he should have some devotees all around him. Right? He should never be alone. Like even in the Satyanarayana photo, you'll see Lakshmi Narayana, Shiva on one side, Brahma on one side, and you'll see some devotees that are drawn. Because Lord should never be alone. Sri Krishna and his various personal expansions are non-different in potential power. These expansions are associated with further secondary expansions or servitor expansions called devotees. So we are servant expansions. We are not master expansions. Vishnu Tattva, Jiva Tattva. Vishnu Tattva means master expansions. So every expansion using that polymorphism and inheritance is still the Supreme Lord. But we are servitor expansions, means we are always servant. Jivora Swarupa Hoy, Nityera Krishna Das. We are always servant of the Lord. Bhakta Adi Krame Kaila Sabara Vandanam.
Bhakta Adi Krame Kaila Sabara Vandanam.
Esa bara vandana sarva shubera karana.
Esa bara vandana sarva shubera karana.
Now Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is saying, I have worshipped all the various levels of devotees. Worshipping them is the source of good fortune. So we should not just say myself and Krishna. That is called Kanishta Adhikari. Kanishta Adhikari means elementary devotee who will only say me and Krishna. As you go to Madhyama Adhikari, then you will have Krishna's forms, Krishna's devotees. And once you go to Uttama Adhikari, if we go to Uttama Adhikari, we see every living entity as a devotee of Krishna. Even though he's like a total rascal, serial killer, murderer, whatever, right? We still say, oh, here is a, you know, devotee of Krishna. Right now he's confused. He's covered with Maya. But he's a devotee of Krishna. That's how Swami Prabhupada saw. So he saw even like, you know, drug addicts and dropouts from college and all kinds of people. And he valued each one of them as a particular level, particular devotee, level of devotee. So to offer prayers to the Lord, one should first offer to his devotees and associates. So that's why we should pray. We should pray to our initiating spiritual master. Just like I say, Tama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vikasa Swami Tinamine. Then to his Guru, Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Tinamine. Then to his Guru, glorifying the Saraswati Goswami, Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Pashyade Satarine. Right? And actually, to be totally perfect, we should pray to the entire parampara, which is there. Where is it? The entire parampara. Bhagavad Gita in the introduction. Have you seen that?
Yeah, introduction. Yeah.
So complete prayer is like this. We have to go through this cycle. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnana Anjana Shalakaya Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhavam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale
Swayam Lokah Padam
Yam Dadati Svabhutantam Deham Shri Guru Shri Padakamalam. See, there's not one guru. There is gurun, means plural. You see this? There are millions of Vaishnava gurus throughout the history of the universe. So we have to pray to all of them. Since we don't know their names, we can say Sri Gurun Vaishnavamsha. Then come to our Parampara Acharya, Rupa Goswami. Sri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunatantitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam. Then you can go to Krishna. You cannot directly go to Krishna. Sri Radha Krishna Padhan Sahagana Lalita Sri Visakhan Vitamsha. So even here we are not going to Krishna. We are going to the gopis, Lalita and Vishakha. So there is right wing gopis and left wing gopis. There are two sets of gopis. They are always competing with each other to serve Krishna. Right? Then comes our Krishna. Everybody's Krishna. Hey Krishna, Na Sindho, Dhina Bhando Jagatpate, Esha Gopika Kantha, Radha Kantha Namostute. Then the most important in the entire universe. Who is that? Higher than Krishna is Radharani. Radharani. Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi, Radhe Vrindavaneshwari, Vishabhanu Devi Pranamami Hari Priye. Then you come back to all the Vaishnavas again. Vanchakalpa Tharubhyascha, Kripasindhya Evacha, Patitakamavanibhyo, Vaishnavebhyo, Om Namaha. Then again, go to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Shri Krishna Chaitanya, Prabhu Nityananda, Shri Advaita Gadadhara, Srivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So it's all there. Information is all there. One should first offer prayers to his devotees and associates. Because it is said that if you directly say Hare Krishna, Krishna will turn to Radharani and say, who is this rascal chanting my name? I never heard of him before. Then Radharani should say, I mean, you have to get Radharani in the good books. She should say, oh my Lord, he is a great devotee of yours. And she will remind Krishna that you are a very good devotee. Right? So directly you cannot go to Krishna. You have to go through the parampara. Because then he'll say, okay, oh yeah, yeah, I know. There is this rascal in Seattle area who forgot me for 10,847 lives and suddenly started chanting Hare Krishna. Because we are all rascals, right? We forgot Krishna for so many millions of lifetimes. So Radharani gives the coordinates. He'll say, no, my Lord, he's very good devotee of yours. She'll give recommendation. Just like to go to college, you need recommendation letter. So Radharani will give us the recommendation letter to Krishna. So always go from bottom to top, not directly to top. Krishna will kick us out. Pratama shloke kahi samanya mangala charanam.
Pratama shloke kahi samanya mangala charanam.
Dvitiya shloke te kari vishesha vandanam.
Dvitiya shloke te kari vishesha vandanam.
In the first verse, general benediction. Second, I pray to Lord in a particular form. So it is good to pray to the Lord in a particular form also, not just general. Vande Sri Krishna Chaitanya Nityananda Sahodito.
Vande Sri Krishna Chaitanya Nityananda Sahodito.
Gaudodaye pushpavantau chitra sandhau tamonudam.
Gaudodaye pushpavantau chitra sandhau tamonudam.
Once my roommate was telling some Westerner, these are the mantras. And the Westerner was like, got confused. Are you such long mantras? Right? So, yeah, this is like, no, this is not like four lines. This is actually two lines. There's a dash here. You see that? This whole thing is one. This whole thing is one. So, offer my respectful obeisances to Sri Krishna Chaitanya, Lord Nityananda, who are like sun and moon. Right? They have arisen simultaneously on the horizon of Gauda to dissipate the darkness of ignorance and wonderfully bestow benediction upon all. Like even if you go to Christian literature, right, you say Christian creation and you look at the images, usually they will show sun and the moon, both of them, in all of the images. You see, they'll show sun, moon like that. So you see this? They say there are pillars of the sky on both sides. They say this is earth, this is the Sheol, where the souls go after death, right? And they always show a sun and a moon, sun and a moon, sun and a moon, like that. And if you look at the broader description of the Vedic tradition, you will see that there is Manasatora mountain, the complete, is forming a loop around the universe. So they have like little, you know, less knowledge. Vedic knowledge is much superior. But if you tell them, they'll start fighting with you. They'll say that Bible is the only way. Jesus is the only way. But actually, you know, in all, this is like a subset of the Vedic, Srimad Bhagavatam. If you read Srimad Bhagavatam, you'll get more detail.
Also, Prabhu, I heard like Jesus Christ also, he spent around 18 years in Jagannath Puri. Like that has also evidence.
Yeah, quite possible actually, quite possible. Because if you see Sant Tukaram also traveled to Jagannath Puri, there was also connection with that, what's his name? Guru Gobind Singh, or not Guru Gobind Singh, this first guru or the second guru. He also had some connection to Jagannath Puri. So there is connection. I mean, it's all not very different. Right now, the Sikhs don't even consider themselves to be part of the Vedic culture. They say, we are very different. But yeah, that's foolishness. There's all connection to the Lord, somehow or the other. Okay. Vrajaye vihare pure Krishna Balarama.
Vrajaye vihare pure Krishna Balarama.
Koti Surya Chandra Jini Donara Nijadama.
Koti Surya Chandra Jini Donara Nijadama.
Sedu I Jagatere Hai Achadayam.
Sedu I Jagatere Hai Sadayam.
Gauda Deshe Purva Shaila Karila Udayam.
Gauda Deshe Purva Shaila Karila Udayam.
Okay, Shiva, read this.
Hare Krishna. Sri Krishna and Balarama, the personalities of Godhead, who formerly appeared in Vrindavana and were millions of times more effulgent than the sun and moon, have arisen over the eastern horizon of Gauda Desa, West Bengal, being compassionate for the fallen state of the world.
Yeah. So basically, just like sun and moon have arisen on the horizon, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu came out of compassion for us, because we forgot our original nature as a soul. We forgot God, and we are so busy with the silly things that we do on a day-to-day basis. So they came 540 years ago to remind us that there is the science of God. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Ara Prabhu Nityanandam.
Shri Krishna Chaitanya Ara Prabhu Nityananda.
Yanara Prakashe Sarve Jagadananda.
Yanara Prakashe Sarve Jagadananda.
The appearance of Sri Krishna and Chaitanya and Prabhu Nityananda has surcharged the world with happiness. Surcharged means it just took it to a next level. Surya Chandra Haye Aiche Sava Andhakara.
Surya Chandra Haye Aiche Sava Andhakara.
Vastu Prakashiya Kare Dharmera Prachara.
Vastu Prakashiya Kare Dharmera Prachara.
He Mata Dui Bhai Jivera Agnana. Tamo nasha kari kaila tatva vastu danam.
Tamo nasha kari kaila tatva
vastu danam. Okay, Manoranjan.
The sun and moon drive away darkness by their appearance and reveal the nature of everything. Those two brothers dissipate the darkness of ignorance, covering the living beings and enlighten them with knowledge of the absolute truth.
Yeah, so dissipate means they took away the darkness. It's like right now it is dark, but tomorrow morning when sun comes, the darkness goes away. Similarly, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu, they dissipate.
Prabhu, here it is mentioned two brothers. But Prabhu, here it is mentioned these two brothers dissipate the darkness of ignorance. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's brother is, what is his name?
Vishwambara. Vishwambara, yeah. No, the brothers means in the sense that they were always preaching jointly. That's the sense. Nityananda Prabhu is born to a different set of mother and father. How does it matter? So we can all call ourselves also as brothers, right? Because we are all learning Chaitanya Charitamrita together in that context. I mean, ultimately, everybody is the brother of everybody in the world. People don't agree with that, but we are all children of same Krishna, right? So we are all brothers.
Also, they are Krishna and Balaram, right? So in that sense as well.
But even Krishna and Balaram are not technically brothers, right? They are cousins to each other. But the point is, they were not born to the same parents anyways. And doesn't have to be. Ultimately, they preach together. So they are brothers. They're always together. More than the brothers would be. So, yeah, that's how we have to understand it. Ajnana tamera nama kahiya kaitava.
Ajnana tamera nama kahiya kaitava.
Dharma artha kama moksha vancha adisabam.
Dharma artha kama moksha vancha adisabam.
So once you get into the flow, right, it feels so sweet to read these verses. So this darkness of ignorance is called Kaitava, cheating religion. So Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, second verse, talks about Kaitava Dharma. Which begins with Dharma, religiosity, Artha, economic development, Kama, sense gratification, and Moksha, liberation. So although liberation is good, there is even something higher than liberation, which is love of God. So even aspiring for liberation is not considered such a great thing. For example, it's a red, Bhuktikami, Muktikami, Siddhikami, Sakala, Ashanta. Krishna Bhakta Nishkama, Athaiva Shanta. Means if you are a Nishkama, no desire Bhakta of Krishna, you're always peaceful, right? Whether there's Black Lives Matter, whether there's Corona or this or that, you don't care. But if you want bhukti, you want to enjoy the fruits of the stock market, or mukti, if you want to get liberated, or siddhi, you want to get some powers. Just like yogis, they can zoom, zoom, zoom from place to place. So yogis come from Himalayas to the Prayag, Allahabad, a distance of what, 800 miles, within a couple of seconds. So, right? Even in the Christian tradition, you have people like witches get onto the brooms and zip, zap, zoom. They go here and there, right? So that's how yogis don't even need a broom. They will just take somebody's hair, meditate on it, and zoop. They use that as the vehicle to go somewhere. They need some physical object to use as a missile or a vehicle, as a, you know, and they are the payload basically. They sit on the payload and zoop, they'll just go there. Even a small stone they will use as a, you know, a rocket, and then they'll just touch the stone, say the mantra, zoom. They are in Prayag. So that is Siddhikama. So, but if you are Muktikama, Siddhikama, or Bhuktikama, then you are always Ashanta. That's why we are never peaceful, right? Because we want a job, we want a nice house, we want a good car. But we will need to come before point of death to that state where all we have is the one piece of cloth on your body and one Japamala in the hand, chant Hare Krishna and get liberated. Yeah. धर्मः प्रोजित कैतवोत्र परमो निर्मत्सराणां सताम्
धर्मः प्रोजित कैतवोत्र परमो निर्मत्सराणां सताम्
वेद्यं वास्तवमत्र वस्तु शिवदं तापत्रयोन्मूलनम्
वेदयं वास्तवमत्र वस्तु शिवदं तापत्रयोन्मूलनम्
श्रीमद्भागवते महामुनिकृते किं वा परेरीश्वरः
श्रीमद्भागवते महामुनिकृते किं वा परेरीश्वरः
सद्यो हृदि अवरुध्यते अत्र कृतिभिः शुश्रूषुभिस्तक्षणात् Okay, Mataji, please read.
The great scripture Srimad Bhagavatam, compiled by Mahamuni Vyasadeva from four original verses, describes the most elevated and kind-hearted devotees and completely rejects the cheating ways of materially motivated religiosity. It propounds the highest principle of eternal religion, which can factually mitigate the threefold miseries of a living being and award the highest benediction of full prosperity and knowledge. Those willing to hear the message of this scripture in a submissive attitude of service can at once capture the Supreme Lord in their hearts. Therefore, there is no need for any scripture other than Srimad Bhagavatam.
Yeah. So we should be willing to hear the message of the scripture in a submissive attitude of service, seva. So when you're hearing, you're actually serving the Lord by hearing about him. When you're eating prasadam, you're serving the Lord by eating prasadam. When you're taking darshan, you're serving the Lord by seeing his beautiful murti form like that. So there is no need for any other scripture. Why? Because you can get the highest benediction of full prosperity and knowledge. So it's not like devotees are poor. Devotees are also rich in a different way. You may see them in just dhoti and kurta. How much does dhoti cost? 300 rupees, 400 rupees. Kurta, another 200 rupees. That's it. And a japmala, maybe another 200 rupees. That's it. But he is very rich. How? He has Krishna trapped in his heart. Right? Krishna is trapped in our heart. If you are a good devotee. So we should become good devotees. Okay, we'll read the purport next time. Let's chant Hare Krishna now.
Okay, Baba.
Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda.
Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda.
Sri Advaita Gadadara Srivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrindam.
Sri Advaita Gadadhara Srivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda.
Okay, let's do it together. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare.